Well, hello there. My name is Alaydriem and welcome back to Bedrock. And today in this episode, we are going to be tackling a couple super duper important farms that we need to get built here right in our path area. First and foremost, we need to get ourselves a pumpkin and a melon farm for two reasons. First, glistening melons, obviously. Second, trading. And did I say two reasons? I meant three. Halloween is coming up and we have no pumpkin decorations to decorate our base with, and that's something that I really wanted to do this year here in our world. So we're gonna go build a farm solely so that we can decorate and make our base look all sorts of spooky for Halloween. Now, I have started here on this farm just a little bit. As you can see, I've placed down quite a bit of powered rails. This was very expensive, but fortunately we have ourselves a gold farm, which makes this very easy to do. Unfortunately, this is really expensive. Really, really expensive. Like, this is all the redstone I have left. So we are going to need to go mine some more redstone down in one of the mines that we have here in our world, and hopefully get enough so that we can finish this project and get it done. Now, like I said, I have done some prep work throughout this entire area. We want to come on down here. Let me see if I can blow this block out real quick. We are using a slightly different system down here to handle everything. I have two mine carts down here that are going to be sweeping over this farm and gathering all the items, but if I can find it here, I think it's right down here. No, it's right down here. We also have a water stream that these will be ejected into and sent all the way into our main sorting system. And this water stream covers the entire length of the path. And I think with the simulation distance that I have on, this should actually be more than sufficient for us to use this entire area as an actual farm if we wanted to move all of our items into there. So have that all built out. But like I said, we are running. Oh, shoot. I probably needed that block, didn't I? Oh, well, we'll go get another one. Like I said, we are going to definitely need to do some additional work to get all the redstone that we need. And for today's mining session, I know the absolute perfect place that we can go in order to grab ourselves all the redstone we need. I've been talking about it for quite a while now, and if you remember, over here across these mountains, there is a chasm with a mine shaft already inside of it. So we can get over there, and yes, I am trying to extend our glide a little bit here on these rockets, because I believe these are once again the last seven rockets that we have, and I would very much not like to use them all getting over here so that I can get out of this hole if I need to. So somewhere over here there is, here it is. Here is this huge chasm with this mine shaft, and I've been talking about needing to explore it for quite some time, and I am just hoping that there is oodles of redstone and other really useful things down here. So we are going to do a, oh, look, there's a spider right there. That's something else we're going to do today. We are going to make ourselves a spider farm, but I'm hoping that down here in these mine shafts, there are plenty of redstone dust that we can gather. So hopefully we won't need to go mining for a little bit longer. So then I am going to get started on that, and I will see you in a little bit. And as usual, the best place to grab redstone is here in this deep, dark area, about -46. But we look at this place. This place is absolutely gorgeous. I know it's just a bunch of red lava, but it's so well lit. There's not a lot of mobs that are actually spawning down here thanks to the light level given by all the lava. And we also have ourselves, I'm guessing that's some deep, dark area over there. I mean, that's a lot of skulk. I tried looking. There isn't an ancient city, but there is a skulk catalyst up there, and I am very, very tempted to use one of my last rockets to get up there. But if I had not already built a base area, this area right here, wow, I would be very interested in having a subterranean base area surrounded by all this lava. I think it would look so, so neat to have that down here. I'm also kind of scared. I think that that's a shrieker over there, so we might be able to summon the warden down here as well if we need to. We'll keep that on tap. Ooh, and look, it's a redstone. We were looking for that. And just to confirm, there is a shrieker down here, and there is the other thing that summons the warden, and I am not in the mood with all the items I have to fight the warden today. Not an ancient city, but we can summon the warden, so we might just have to keep this on the back burner, because this is a little quicker to get to than our other area that we had mined out, and we might have actually destroyed all of our shriekers in that other area. So we're going to grab this last bit of redstone, keep this on the back burner of our mind, and happily take all of our redstone back over to base and see what our haul looks like. And back at our base, the most efficient way to gather our redstone is to build it into a giant tower and then use fortune on it. Makes it a little bit better. We actually grabbed some diamonds in our area, but let's go ahead and gather all of this up and take just a look-see at what we have over here. Where is... I have a spare chest. Nope, that's bone meal. That's dirt. Why do I have a chest of bone meal and dirt over here? Okay, I have a shulker box. Let's take our shulker box. And then over here, we can just take a little look inside. So how many do we have here? It looks like we have 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 13 and a little over a half. And I think I actually have, we actually have some redstone in here. So almost 13 stacks of redstone dust. So hopefully that should last us a little bit longer, maybe a week or so. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. But with our redstone now collected, we are now in a position to start building the rest of this farm. So why don't you sit back, relax, enjoy the music, and let's build ourselves a pumpkin and a melon farm. One really long time later, actually. Building this farm took a really long time. We have ourselves, though, a pumpkin and a melon farm. And as you can see, we are producing quite a bit now that these stems have grown up. This farm took a really long time to build. And not because it's complex, but because I kept having a couple of issues with accidentally placing water in the wrong spot and then wiping out all of the crops I had placed and then all of the rail that I had placed down below. So I had to rebuild this bottom layer about 6 or 7 times, but all of these items, I don't know if you can hear it down there, are being sent into our water stream, and they are being sent all the way back to our main storage system here in our mansion. So we now have ourselves plenty of things coming in here, pumpkins and glistening, well, not glistening melons yet. They will be glistening melons. That's what we're going to use them for. But you want to come over here to where our storage system is. Just take a look over here. We, we've done some work over here. You know, just a little bit. I had some ideas about what I wanted to do. Made this a straight shot into here. We'll worry about enclosing that area off maybe a little bit later. But coming on down here, you won't believe this. I only have AFK'd for a couple of hours here. There's a sugar cane. There is our kelp. But over here, that's 3 chests of melon slices and then almost 3.5-ish. Of pumpkins. We have plenty of pumpkins that we've converted and then some more melon slices over here. So we have plenty of supplies at this point. I'm probably going to need to put a switch on that farm to light up all of those redstone dust so that our farm actually stops working in the meantime. Because I don't know if you can tell, we have a lot of pumpkins and melons now, and I don't think we need any more. This is probably more than enough to last us through, I don't know, maybe the rest of the season. I don't know. We'll see. I have lots of other thoughts that I want to do with this, but we'll see where this lasts us for now. And with our pumpkin and melon farm and now completed, the only outstanding task that we have left to do in this episode is build ourselves a string farm. Now, if you remember in our previous episode, we built ourselves a bamboo farm down here in our path area. And the whole point of this is to one day build a gunpowder farm so that we can never worry about our rockets ever again. That's my goal. I don't want to worry about rockets ever again because it is one of the worst ways to ruin the elytra experience. I just want to be able to fly when I want to and do a lot more exploring, and I just can't do that because of all these caves and cliffs. So, had a couple ideas of how I wanted to do this. Thought about using maybe some of our cats in our base, but I decided to give just a quick little peek around the world. And you know, would you believe it or not? Right down here, inside of this cave system, not far from our base, right here in the corner, is a spider spawner. Yep. I thought that we'd have to go hunting for these for days and days and days. But I was down here exploring and look right here. Cave spider spawner. So simple. So this is gonna be a pretty simple farm. All we need is a spawner, a bunch of magma blocks, and then just a really basic collection system to collect all of our loot. I'm gonna go ahead and make this so that these guys can't spawn, and we will get cracking with getting this done. And if you haven't ever made a spawner farm like this before, this type of farm is actually really, really simple, assuming that you have access to the Nether and can get all of these magma cubes. All that we are going to do, and this should work for, I think, any type of these naturally generated spawners, is carve ourselves out a 10-ish by 10-ish area around our spawner here. We're going to place some blocks above it, and then about 6 or 7 blocks down, we are just going to build a whole bunch of magma cubes in a wall so that things can't climb out, and then throw some water streams in, and hopefully everything should spawn at a relatively fast pace, and then we can start collecting all of our loot just by dropping them down onto the magma. So down here, again, very, very simple, just a 10 by 10 area. We're gonna build up these magma walls right here. And the only reason I'm doing this is because I don't want the spiders trying to crawl out. These magma blocks will prevent them from climbing up the side because they're not a spawnable or climbable block super much. Sometimes they can climb them, but for the most part they can't. They'll take damage the whole way. But we have this extra lip right up here and the spiders can't climb over that. So hopefully all of our spiders should stay down here in our kill chamber that we are creating for them. And after adding in our water streams, we can see our spider spawner is now complete. And like I said, this should work for any of these natural spawners that we have right here. You could use this with skeletons too as well, so it shouldn't be a problem. But I've been letting this run AFK for a couple of hours. I didn't build a trident farm down here, or sorry, a trident killer, but we're gonna take a look down here. We have quite a bit of spiders down here, but as you can see, you know, for a couple of hours of AFK, this is actually quite a bit of loot. So I'm pretty happy with this. Obviously, if I wanted to make this more efficient, we've had lots of spider jockeys. There's something I didn't think of. Yeah, so if we wanted to make this more efficient and take care of these mobs right down here, we probably should have built a trident killer of some kind. I have a design for that. You can go check it out down in the description. I might end up doing that just a little bit later, but for now, honestly, this is more than enough string that we're going to need for any of the farms that we're going to be building. But I think with that set, we are now actually in a really good position to begin our creeper farm here in the next episode. But that's going to be all the time that we have for today. As always, thank you so much for watching. I always appreciate you watching these videos. If you enjoyed this video, please consider liking, subscribing, maybe leaving a comment. And remember, you're always welcome on Bedrock. I'll see you next time. Bye.